Chair recognizes the gentleman from Colorado, Mr. Tipton.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Secretary, for being here today. But actually, I'd like to go back to a little bit of some of the earlier questioning that was going on when you made reference that the Geological Service and others have had outreach by the BLM to companies. A question that I would like to explore with you is several states have rules in place regulating hydraulic fracking. These regulations have been carefully crafted in stakeholder conversations with major parties and industry. And I'd like to know, did the Department of Interior consult with states and with tribes in regards to BLM regulations?
Congressman Tipton, we have had a massive outreach effort that has included input from tribes and states and industry and environmental community and everybody else. And so that is being reflected, and there will be other opportunities to do that as we move forward with the formal rulemaking process.
Okay. In terms of it being reflected, I do have a letter from the governor of North Dakota expressing his concerns with the new regulations. And I am curious, what response did you receive from Governor Hickenlooper and the state of Colorado in regards to new BLM regulations?
You know, I was with the governor of Colorado, John Hickenlooper, on Saturday night. We did not discuss these issues. We discussed other issues related to potential resolution of conflicts between the federal government and the state of Colorado. But this is, at the end of the day, your question goes to outreach to states that already have developed regulations in the way that Colorado and North Dakota have done. I think that's important, and I admire what they have done in Texas and in other places. I do think that it's important for us as the steward of the public estate and the 700 million acres of mineral estate that we oversee on behalf of the American people, that we have the set of rules that govern those lands. And that's what we intend to do through the efforts of the Bureau of Land Management.
And I understand your position on this, but I would like to know, why do you believe that the Department of Interior should usurp state authority to regulate hydraulic fracking? The well construction in western states like Colorado have been doing it safely for decades, as we've heard throughout numerous western states as well. In fact, we had testimony just a few weeks ago with Director Abbey, Harris Sherman, former Secretary Babbitt, noting that over a million fracking operations had taken place with no incident, dealing with state regulations that had been in place. So what flaws in state regulations were reached through consensus with industry, local governments, and environmentally, did the department really lead you to try and enact different regulations as opposed to having state involvement?
Scott, the outreach that we did to the states included meetings in Bismarck, North Dakota, in Golden, Colorado, and those were led by the BLM to get input from those respective states. Now, I think your question really goes to the fact that if you have states now coming on board and saying that they're going to develop their own regulatory regime, why is it necessary for the United States to develop its regulatory regime on public lands? My answer to that is I think we have a responsibility. I believe we have a responsibility under the laws of this country to make sure that the 700 million acres of the American citizen-owned public estate, that we are taking care of those lands in a way that any land manager, any landowner would do. In addition to that, Congressman Tipton, I would also add that I think there are many in the industry who have spoken to me who have said that they would rather have a standard that they can follow from state to state so they're not subjected. You know, almost most of the companies that are involved in hydraulic fracking and natural gas production operate across many state lines. And what I always hear from industry is that they don't like to deal with the patchwork of regulation that makes it difficult for them to address different sets of regulations. So our regulations will deal only with the public estate, but it also seems to me that it may create the template for what ought to be happening across the country as well.
You know, we have in some of the states with the most stringent requirements for disclosure in particular, websites called Frack Focus, but yet the BLM makes no reference to it in terms of their proposals. So in the draft legislation worded indicates that the BLM intends to set up, at the cost to taxpayers, a whole new database. I think this is something of concern that we're seeing reflected at multiple levels, that we're having stealth tax increases, as Mr. Duncan noted at the pump, that are ultimately the American taxpayers having to pay for bureaucratic regulations tiered from the state to the federal government and duplication going on.
If I may, Mr. Chairman, I'd like our Deputy Secretary just to describe frac focus for a minute and how we're using it as well, because I think it's of interest to members of the committee.
Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to respond very quickly, the Congressman is referring to a draft proposal that is not our proposed rule. We are working on a proposed rule that will be fully fully available for comment. We are very interested in making sure that disclosed information is available to everybody. We will explicitly be asking for comment on how we can interact with frac focus and other state-based disclosure issues, because we have no interest in creating any conflict with state regulation. In fact, as the Secretary said, we want to conform and help work together with the leading states who are engaged in this exercise.
Time of the gentleman has expired.